Hey everyone, it's Jen over at jenscrappypages.blogspot.com, and today's project is this really cute thank you card that is pretty darn simple and quick to throw together. I got my order yesterday. Woo woo! it was kind of a boring order. I just got cardstock, like white cardstock, Whisper White, and I got a whole bunch of adhesive. So now I finally have my Stampin Dimensionals back again, which I was kind of lost without them. But I did treat myself and I bought this background stamp called A World of Thanks. So I sat down and played around with it a little bit last night and added a little bit of glimmer paper to this. I know I've been kind of sticking with like a monochromatic cards lately, just a one cardstock color and the Whisper White cardstock, but I don't know, I just kind of like the look of it. So I made one in mint macaron, and then, well, of course, because there's two other colors to the glimmer paper, I made these two. So this one is sweet sugar plum, and this one is Bermuda Bay. And again, with the Bermuda Bay, I didn't have the ink for it, so I decided to stamp out the background in black and the thank you so much. So I just love the way all three of these came together. These would make a really good gift card set, I think. You know, make two of each and package them up in a nice little bow with some envelopes. So let's get started with the products that I used. The Mint Macaron satin ribbon. And of course, the Mint Macaron ink pad. This background stamp, a world of thanks. So as you can see, it's many different thank yous. And then kind of my new favorite, thankful thoughts. This is really why I bought the stamp set. I kept looking across that in the catalog and finally I just bought it. Layering circles, framelits, dies. And this time, believe it or not, I did not use my stitched shapes. So for paper, you're going to need, if you want to do the mint macaron one, it's mint macaron 5.5 by 8.5, a strip of 1 by 5.5, and then Whisper White 3.75 by 5, a 3.5 by 3.5 for my large circle, and a 5/8 of an inch by 5.5. And then a 3.5 by 3.5 of the glimmer paper. We are going to start with our stamping first. Move those out of the way. And what I'm gonna do is, this card feels like it's in the way. Maybe if I move it up over there. I'm gonna bring my stamp over and then our mint macaron. And I did use, the Archival Basic Black on my stamp and did not wash it off right away like I probably should have. It's stained, but it doesn't, I mean, it still stamps just fine with all the other colors. So that's why mine looks a little bit dark. So we're just gonna ink it up really good on this block. I'm sure it's probably inked, but I just wanna make sure. And then my thank you is going to be at the top part of it. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to line up the very bottom of my stamp here with the bottom of my 3.75 by 5. And the reason I chose this size is because it fits just perfect on there with not much white space around it. So I'm just going to line this up here and kind of press down on it. There! Looking good, huh? So that's done. And then we're gonna take the 3.5 by 3.5, and I'm just gonna go ahead and stamp up this one. Get that inked up really good. Make sure I'm still on the screen here. Hopefully I don't get my head in the way. We're just gonna probably put this somewhere in the middle. Now let's grab out the handy dandy Big Shot. So I'm just gonna kind of clear this space here to bring it out. And we're just gonna cut out both of these at the same time. Your circle is gonna go here, and that goes pretty much, it just fits in that largest circle in the layering circles framelits. All right, so there's that. And then we're gonna score or fold. If you're new to my videos, I prefer to fold it because I feel like I have better control over getting my edges matched up. I swear half the time I score it, I end up with crooked, and that bothers me. So I have better control over just using it by hand like that. We're just gonna attach it with some snail adhesive. And that's just gonna go in the center here. I've used this layout before. It's a pretty simple layout. And it goes together pretty quickly. And this is just gonna go in the center of your strip. And I like using this 5/8 inch strip because it's just slightly larger than the ribbon. Okay, we'll take the ribbon and we're gonna wrap around the edges. And for this, I want to put enough adhesive, because it's going to be a little bit bulky here with this ribbon. So I like to make sure that that's got plenty of adhesive stuck to the ribbon and stuck to the edges of the cardstock as well, just to make sure that it sticks down. Because I've had times where it'll start kind of poking back up again if I don't get enough. And that's just going to go here in the center. And then I'm going to use just some glue dots to glue down my circle onto that glitter, because the glitter, sometimes it doesn't want to stick to just the regular snail adhesive, at least I've found. So I feel like the dots give me a little bit more stick. And I'm just going to throw one here in the center just for good measure. And that's just going to go in the center here. So you have just a little bit of the sparkle peeking out. And then my dimensionals, I'm just going to put it at the top and the bottom of... I need these on this side. Okay, so they're gonna go on the top and the bottom because I have this bulk here in the middle, so. I'm just gonna throw that down, oh, I don't know, probably half an inch from this side. And then I'm just gonna tie a bow. With my mint macaron. And if you like this color, this is one of the 2015-2017 in colors. So at the end of our current catalog, it will be retiring. I really love this color. So I'm just gonna try and work my way into the perfect bow. I don't know, perfect. That's possible, but we're gonna try. So that looks about right. I think I might move it over just a tad. I don't know, is that too big? I'm just gonna leave it. All right, that is good enough. I'm just gonna call it good. Isn't that pretty? I just love the soft color of that mint macaron. And then here's all three of the cards together. I just think it would make a really pretty gift set, or, well, I guess just even to send out individually. So simple too, just a couple of stamps and a little bit of shimmer and ribbon, and you have a really cute card. If you would like to stop by my blog, jenscrappypages.blogspot.com, and I will have printable, downloadable instructions in the PDF form if you would like. Otherwise, I will catch you later. Bye.